Now you go. No worries.
Didn't realise this race had every power up in. Burritos, ghosts, anvils.
Anvils as well.
Paul just took the fastest through segment. Nice one, Paul.
Nice one, mate.
If that mattered for anything.
Morning, Ian. I did the recce of the ZRL, the Piglet, and out of respect for him and Wahoo Lacol, I didn't stream it. I didn't want, you know, if we talk about different teams' tactics, for it to be a matter of record on the internet. And last minute, we decided to do this as well. And this isn't important. So, can stream it for everyone to see. Yeah. Well, I'm honestly just excited anytime anyone comments on a video of mine, because I'm amazed anyone wants to watch it. So
off the Titus Grove, is the forward or the reverse?
Forward.
Yeah, forward, yeah.
Okay, so and then Volcano and then everything back in reverse, I guess.
Yeah. These burrito bastards already.
Ben will be loving it. That's his favourite time, isn't it, burritos?
It's an arrow rider as well.
How is it?
you going shopping, Ben? Have a good one, mate. Do some curls with the bags. There's weights. Morning, Mick. Hey, Manuel. Thank you, mate.
I might just try a bit of a soft attack, just to stretch things a little.
Yeah.
It'll only be a minute, just to see if people are paying attention. Stretching quite nicely.
Yeah.
I think another 20 seconds and I'll call it.
Is it your first time on the course, Paul?
Yes, of course. I thought there was a hill here, but it's disappeared. So first little ramp, I might push again just to do the same stretching, because it's stretching quite a lot, surprisingly.
Morning, Phil. Morning, Ben. We're just stretching. Because it's such a big blob, and there's a lot of bees, we thought we'd string it out of it. And some guy in the chat asked if we'd never ridden this course before.
I'm not going to go hard, but just try and stretch, really.
Just around this right-hander here?
Yeah, once it starts pitching, I'll just roll through, really. Right, you can all sit in if you need to. Just stay in the first 10 or 20 if it does snap a wee bit.
Nice.
Yeah, it's not really stretched very much, but it's better than it was.
Burrito. Hand slip, not
that super strong Spanish guy's in here. Yeah. But I can't pronounce his name, he's likely to go at some point. I might try and stretch it a little bit just before the start of the climb, or the climb proper anyway. Though it is a little bit stretch, just not very.
The Spanish guys at Moreno?
No, a Peptach, T-A-T-C-H-E. Oh, Peptach, yeah. Cool. Heavy but very, very powerful. I might squeeze it just after the next hairpin.
Yes, mate, yeah. Thank you. My God, we got a lot of running pork in my chat this morning. Sixteen's a bit old for me, Kelvin. Oh God. Oh God, that came out wrong. 16's a bit old for me to be beating. It's all held together.
Yeah, it's just too drafty, isn't it? Everyone knows.
At the moment, yeah.
Stretching a bit now. That little bit snapped a couple off.
Yeah, I started from the back, dropped the burrito and sprinted through. I think it helped.
Very nice.
God damn it. Yeah, I think down to 50 after Titans Grove isn't bad. So drafty, so I think that's decent.
Yeah, it was 75, now it's 54, which is alright.
Phil, I really do go that sideways. I don't know why. It's something about the trainer. Because any footage of me outdoors, I don't do it at all. There's no sway. Yeah, Manuel, this is Bigfoot Hills. It's a great race. Give me this over ZRL any day. Go, mate.
Oh, yes. Kick on the flat.
Pep's gone. Thank you.
stretching it.
Hey, Tommy.
It might snap, but unlikely. Just too connected, unfortunately.
Yeah, I'm towards the back anyway, so trying to get forwards, I'm struggling.
Everyone coming through. And I am last.
Yeah, Tommy, living in paradise. Tell us about it, mate. It's grey and rainy here.
Interesting dynamics there. I was first
good
over.
Good luck, guys. I'm just showing to it.
Alright, mate.
Yeah, cool. Good stuff. We'll catch you Tuesday.
Yeah, hopefully form will be back by then.
I'm sure it will.
If it was like last week, it will.
Tommy, you got the Rona. Tommy, can I be really nosy and ask how life ended up with you living out, is it near Rimini? Like, you Irish originally? Living out there? Just curious, because it looks amazing. Is it work? Flamily? Something else? I had quite a hard time on that one, so I don't know how I'll do up the volcano. I'll just ride it a bit defensively, see if I can hang on.
Yeah, it's a lot more drafty, isn't it? So
yeah.
Gives you a bit of play, like a 2.5-3 minute effort, then a little bit of drafting and another couple of minutes, a tiny bit of drafting and a punch.
Cool.
Just sort of break it down in your head.
Yeah, good call. Oh, Tommy, living the dream. Okay. I don't know how you say Riccione. I don't know. But anyway, My parents used to go there.
I do have a burrito, which I don't like. I might have to use it on that last pitch, yeah. Maybe.
I was going to say, yeah. If you do a full effort on that climb and drop it, it might help.
Yeah, just that final pitch up, maybe, just before it or something.
Yeah.
Seems a waste to throw it.
Get a gap before the steep bit. Like,
yeah, run into it hard and then hit it while I'm going through the group sort of thing.
I love Vienna. Me and Rhiannon have been on holiday there. And it's probably my favourite European city I've visited. Except the mighty Liverpool, of course.
Oh, we've got a banner here, haven't we?
Yeah, we have, yeah.
Yeah, we'll check it away then.
Oh, cool. Rich surname. Yeah, my parents used to go to a hotel called Hotel Belvedere, I think, and you hire bikes and it's catered and stuff, and you just ride for 7 days or something. I got bloody burrito, mate.
Nice. Draft van here.
Oh, good, that'll be useful for you.
Yeah, not bad for the volcano.
Yeah, I understand that, Tommy. That's what I found about Munich as well. In my stream chat, Kelvin's annoyed that you didn't leave me out then burrito me.
Oh dear. I wouldn't do anything like that. That's just mean.
Yeah. I don't know if you saw, that's what he did to me in ZRL. Bastard.
What, last week?
Yeah, because we got spat out the back. It was just the two of us. And we were like a minute ahead of the group behind and a minute behind the group ahead, so we were just having a laugh. He got a burrito, dropped it and sprinted.
Excellent. So officially he got more points than you on the line from dropping you there.
He was actually at a banner as well, like a division, so he got 11 and I got 10 for that one place.
Ah, brilliant. That is funny.
Yeah, it was. Never going to forgive him, of course.
Yeah, I bet you haven't slept since. Another burrito dropped. I just don't see why you drop it there.
No.
I don't understand it, really.
It's made a little gap. I know we'll close it again, but the person who dropped it is in the back group.
Yeah. I can understand if you're attacking, but not when you're halfway down the group. God knows.
Yeah, clearly, Katie. I've got my companion app ready with the bin there, because I doubt there's going to be any opportunity for me to use it. Yeah, the eat option should refuel you slightly.
Looks like a gentle attack at the front.
Yeah. I'm out that front,
groupmates.
Good luck.
Just hang in, might come back.
Cycling too fast. I agree. It's so disheartening to see. I'm out the back. 10 viewers lost. Sorry, guys.
Drop out.
I was going to say, I can't see you on the... I was trying to fan view you.
Yeah, that's good.
Got it.
That's another game. That's any game.
Yeah, just back here. You can get that. Yeah, it wasn't actually 10, it was 5 that dropped out.
I'm done.
Fair play, mate. After that dropout, that's brutal.
Yeah, that's rough, man.
Good timing. Oh, someone's been coming. I thought it was pretty fast up here.
Yeah. Not surprised. Hey, Manuel. It wasn't a dig. It was just a comment on how funny it is to go, oh, this is so hard. There's a gap. And everyone just goes, I can't be bothered with this anymore. Burrito in the bin, I'm afraid, David. Katie, are these official names, or are you doing your best Ainsley Harriet impression? Sally Salt and Percy Pepper? Hey chat, I've got a little tease for you. A little tease, so I've got something to talk about. But I recorded a few more things yesterday. They're not... Lord, no, this is super old jersey. I bought this. It's really, really thin, really light. And I bought it for when I did my tour of Thailand with my dad. Because we're pasty northern boys with Irish blood. And we thought we'd be too hot in 30 degree northern Thailand. So I went on Wiggle. I wasn't cycling much then, by the way. So I didn't have any kit that fit me, because I was 8 kilos heavier than I am now. I went on Wiggle, and I bought the thinnest tops I could find for the cheapest price. And I like this one. It was only 20 quid, but it's sportful, and it's very thin. It's looser on me now than it was then. And it worked, because one day I wore a jersey that was, it's Castelli, and it's meant to be like a summer jersey, but it's got a little bit of weatherproofing in it, and I love it. It's one of my favourite looking and feeling jerseys, but it's just a bit less breathable, and that was on the fifth day in Thailand. It hit 37 Celsius.
There's a couple just behind me. The guy's trying to get a little kid to work with him.
Okay. Yeah, that's 16-year-old.
Yeah.
I think
he said, now you'll go.
I might put a bit of a bit of an effort in as well.
Yeah, you're easy to catch him because it's just one guy.
Yeah, fair.
I think the young lad's got a very low watts, so
he's so very quick.
Yeah.
So anyway, one day in Thailand, I got heat stroke because I was wearing a thick jersey. That was a very rambling story that no one really cares about. And they had to put me in the air-conditioned van. And I like this jersey better. Fuck me, I'm boring. Sorry, guys. It took me ages to get that story just because Lord asked if I had a new jersey. No one cares. The video. I just made it yesterday. I didn't put any effort into recording it. Believe it or not, I actually put effort into these hill climb ones. I know it doesn't seem like it, because it's a very boring video, just of a handlebar camera on a hill. But I do have a think about where to film a little intro and, you know, what to do. But on the ride, I just turned my camera on a couple of times for other bits that I thought might be interesting. One's a nice descent that hopefully you'll enjoy. Only 3 minutes. And one is a hill I've never done before. And it's kind of cool, actually. For being a bit of a nothing road from one small village to an even smaller village, it had like 4 25% switchbacks. So I'm hoping the front camera will have caught that. That goes live today. I uploaded the video maybe at 4 today. My loyal fans. Look at this. Look at this. Grade 19%. I've never ridden this hill before. anyway, let's see what's going on Zwift. I know, David. One day I might have 50 subscribers, and then I'll be quitting the day job, phoning Mr. Unilever and saying science doesn't pay. 50 YouTube subscribers. I'm hitting the big time. I don't think we're going to get you. You're putting some time into us, very nice.
Yeah, I think your group's not, what's the word, cohesive.
Yeah, not at all, no. Cheers, Tommy. It's basically the same thing again. Slightly different hill. Well, a different hill. Calling you into TTT rotations.
Oh yeah.
Fair play.
And like normal, everyone's doing it.
Yeah.
Which is wonderful.
Yeah. Oh, for fuck's sake.
Oh yeah, we're up in the ante now.
6 watts per kilo for a minute. Something over an hour into this race.
25k to go.
I'm just going to wait till Titans Grove. Kill these guys or die. We're not going very fast, so...
Yeah, the front will keep rolling away steadily.
Yeah, exactly.
Unless you're in the team time trial group.
Are you reeling them in?
Very slowly, yeah. We'd need about 70k to make it doable. Yeah. Minute 50 at the moment, I think.
If it splits over Titans Grove, you might get some stragglers.
Yeah, true. There is two guys in the gap. Oh, he's changed his mind now.
Yeah, he started it and decided that was too hard.
Oh yes.
It's bizarre, isn't it, Ian?
I know they've let a gap appear. Bloody hell.
Piglet had a dropout board. It's not quite the same when your internet drops out halfway up the volcano. With Pep Tash leading the front, sort of inevitable. If he had a dropout on a normal day, I think he'd have closed it, but with Pep plus a bot, someone got coned in that front group. Thank you. you're back for my sad, slow finish. Just didn't have the legs for the volcano today. Percent, Lord.
Here he goes again. He's doing us up.
Yeah. My attack was absolutely futile because there were two of them. They did like half a watt per kilo less than me and still just caught me.
Marvellous.
Thank you. Cheers, Ben. I achieved literally nothing.
Okay, the orders are out.
That's it. Forget Nick's notes. This man's talking. I'm not going to give him hell of a sprint load, because I'm going to drop him up the reverse comm, obviously. David Raynham timeout. Outrageous. I made David a moderator, so when he comes back, he'll be a moderator wars. Yeah, I did, Tommy. It was very mild. It was just like I was getting to the point that I couldn't cool down and I felt like my legs didn't work. But once I got in the aircon and off the bike, it didn't take me long to feel fairly well recovered. And the following day was a rest day, so say a rest day. It was 60 kilometers and 3 hours on a boat. Terrifying boat. Like a little canoe up rapids for 3 hours with our bikes in the boat. Yeah, it ended up being 80 kilometers as well, because the boat drivers, is that what they're called? The boat captains, I guess. Anyway, they said they couldn't make it to the town we wanted to go to because sand mining, basically corporations were taking the sand from the banks of the river to sell, and it made the river really wide and really shallow, and they said we wanted to go too far upstream to have three people and three bikes in their boat. Our local tour guide said that's nonsense, and they just realised they wouldn't make it there and back for dinner, so they made us get out. Literally on a riverbank in the jungle, they just said, you know, this is as close as we'll take you, hop out. And we had to walk carrying our bikes to the road and then ride along some jungle path for 20k. So I was a grump that day. Legs didn't have it. It was a long way to go. And I won't lie, I'm not the most adventurous person. So even though I was with 10 people, being dumped on a riverbank in the Thai jungle with just my bike, didn't even have my bags or anything, because we hired a van driver to drive them from hotel to hotel. So we got off that riverbank. Okay, I was with my dad, but we were both just... I'm not too proud to admit, I was pretty shit scared. I could ramble about this all day, because that ended up being our favourite day on the bikes, because halfway through this little jungle walk, we came to a tiny village, and I mean like 10 houses, but there was a primary school in it, and the locals seeing, you know, 10 white men with bikes in the middle of Thai jungle just came out to see what's going on. Obviously they didn't speak a lick of English, we didn't speak a lick of Thai, but they gestured to ask if we were hungry. We said yeah, and they basically told us that for, I think it was like 20p, we could go into this primary school canteen and they'd feed us. So we just had like a noodle soup thing, paid them 20 pence, but we were all sitting on these kids' chairs. And it was great. You know, it wasn't the most exciting meal I've ever had, but it was just such a bizarre experience. Yeah, seems indeed. It was... yeah, quite possibly, Tommy. Yeah, quite possibly. I know it's like, it's a massive cliche, bordering on a bit jingoistic, but I couldn't believe how friendly everyone was. It's just a different sort of way of life. So when we popped into places like that, because we were a bit of a novelty, everyone was excited to see us. wanted photos with us, but you know, people just couldn't do enough for you.
The Sergeant Major has attacked.
No! How's he going to...
Oh, yes.
He's off the front.
Yeah, 30 minutes of team time trial. And now he's gone.
Yeah. Thanks for carrying me this far, lads. I'll see you again.
Have a nice day. And they're chasing.
Of course. My group's just relentlessly attacking each other. Well, I think they're attacking me because I'm not the fair enough. Why did it make you feel like an idiot, Ben? I mean, it made me feel uncomfortable for lots of reasons.
I think Sergeant May just blowing up a little bit.
You reckon that was just the last ditch effort of war and die?
Of frustration.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's now sitting at under five. He's got 5 seconds, but I don't think that's enough.
So alien to me, just because, well, I don't need to make myself sound.
And now they're ripping into his lead.
Nice.
He's going to give us detention, I think.
Oh, do you know what, I'll have a philosophical ramble about West meets East after this con. Yeah, tell me about it, Ben. I know exactly what you mean.
We're back with the Sergeant Major, but the young lad is dropped.
Yeah, race, Kelvin. What were you expecting?
Oh, I can see ginger numbers. Oh, yes, there's a gap.
Nice. My group's still just dicking about with each other.
Yeah, so I was just watching. Good punches everywhere.
Shattered tank. I forgot how much a 4.5 hour outdoor ride will take out of you.
Yeah, absolutely, yeah. Just time in the saddle. A lot of calories burnt. Captain's gone again.
Oh, he might get there this time.
Yeah, 3.6.
Depends what gap he's got.
Yeah.
Nah, Ben, there's nothing in my legs. If these guys go to a sprint finish, so be it. My legs are absolutely empty. Piglet's telling us about the guy in his group who's been aggressive in the chat, organising them into a TTT. He's been really funny. Like, typing rotations in, typing power numbers, and they all did it.
He's back and he's going again.
Yeah, he is.
He's a bit of a star, isn't he, this guy?
I love it. Keeps it interesting. I had a chance to watch Phil stream yesterday, it was busy. I think I'm learning that I haven't done enough threshold work recently. I've just got nothing around.
Nothing there.
I think because I was relying on the TTTs to do it and we've missed quite a few.
Yeah.
No, I'm sure it'll come back quickly if I put a bit of time in thinking about it, but I'm absolutely fine punching at 7, but I can only sit at 3.
Yeah, that's the difference, isn't it?
Hi, Kyle. I think you missed the start and the middle, and most of the end. There's a lad who was 1:20 behind us, who's now 5 seconds. He's just sitting at 7 watts per kilo. Bloody hell.
That's the guy who they wanted to flag, isn't it?
Is it? Hubel.
Yeah.
Sitting at 7 to 8 watts per kilo for long times.
Suspicious.
I'm dead. Let's not forget that I did a full recce with sprints of the ZRL as a warm up to this. There you go. Ah, error. Cheers, guys. Whew. That was a hard morning. Did Sergeant Major win it from your group?
No, he was sort of attacking with 6s and 7s.
Yeah.
So he never really got much more than 3 or 4, which meant some of the guys chased. So about 2k out, I just sat at the back while they were chasing and then rolled through once I caught him.
Ah, nice.
It was a normal. And then just watched the Sergeant Major was trying to catch, just matched his numbers. And then clicked on him, checked his speed, checked my speed.
Yeah.
With the normal sort of thing.
Nice.
Yeah, I didn't fancy a full-on sprint.
No, fair enough. I decided to wait until the sprint. I did about 5 seconds and then gave up, so I just rolled in.
Your little mini war.
Yeah,
with those two. Yeah, good stuff.
Sure enough, this boobal fella has done nearly 5 watts per kilo average for the whole.
Nice. Good legs day anyway.
Yeah, definitely. Right, mind a leg day. Thank you for that.
Yes, me too.
Are
yeah, have a good one.
Showing your mate doing the Everesting.
I'll go and check, yeah, where he is. But earlier, he was descending down when I caught him. So rolled down, turned, and I started doing 2.5, 3 watts a kilo. And he was doing 4.5.
Oh.
So he was basically sitting at 350, 380,
yeah.
400. It's like, well, I can't keep you company here.
No.
This is not good. So I'll join him now and just see what's what.
Yeah.
I'm pretty sure he'll be going way too quick for me.
All right. Enjoy the rest of your day, mate. Please
yes, I'll see you. See you Tuesday.
Yeah, see you Tuesday. Bye.
Cheers, Nick. Have a good one.
Thank you, Stream. Thanks for keeping me company. Yeah, it was a heavy morning after yesterday's ride as well. I think feet up for the rest of the day and maybe not a red wine, but you may or may not remember from Phil Lovett's video that my girlfriend makes a mean sourdough. So I want a piece of sourdough toast right now. That's what I mean. And maybe a coffee. Right. Love you all. Thanks for keeping me company. 4 o'clock, another hill video is going up if you're interested in Nick cycling up hills. If you're not interested in Nick cycling up hills, absolutely no obligation to watch my fairly shit videos. Right. See you all soon.